With DoubtNit, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry, and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question, and get instant video solution. Download DoubtNit app today.
Hello students, in this given question, we need to answer, a scalar-planar complex is formed by hybridization of which of the following orbitals? So, this is going to be a theoretical question and answer is going to be option B directly. Because it is being formed from the contribution of d x square minus y square orbitals, then px, then py and correspondingly s orbital. So, which we can see over here like this. This is the d orbital which we usually see. We are also going to take one example to explain this phenomena, what is happening over here. Then this is the s orbital, then these are the p. So basically the hybridization, that is dsp2 types will be formed, and dsp2 will be giving a total of 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 hybrid orbital will be formed over here, which are of dsp2 type, having same energy. And moreover, this will be our contributing from dx square minus y square, this orbital. Then comes our s orbital, then this is px and py. So this was the contribution and this is our answer. So all this we need to consider with respect to this given question. And now I am taking one example of the complex for explaining you. So takes nickel, then carbonyl, tetracarbonyl over here I have taken. So how to go with the complex? First of all, calculate the oxidation state. So x, this is neutral ligand, so 0 multiplied by number 4, and overall charge not given, we assume it to be 0. So this states that nickel is present in ground state only, and configuration for ground state is already known to you, because it is having 28 atomic numbers. So this is argon 4s2 and 3d8. So this will be its electronic configuration. If I represent in the diagram, so this is 3d orbital 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and this 4s2, and already 4p is already vacant. Now if you see with respect to nature of the ligand present over here, this is carbonyl, which is a strong field ligand. So what it will cause? It will cause pairing of these electrons. So this orbital will be vacant, so there will be back shifting due to strong field ligand over here. So this orbital inner, which is going to be, so if we work on this complex, this is going to be paired one over here, and after back shifting this is also being paired. So over here the hybridization is going to be sp3. So this is correspondingly tetrahedral, which is not our answer. Now we need to take same other example for that. So I have taken another example of NiCN whole 4 2 minus complex, which is being taken over here to explain you the concept of square planar geometry. So basically same step would be done which we have done for the tetrahedral one. So this is sino negative ligand, so minus 1 multiplied by 4, and this is overall equation. So value comes out to be plus 2 only, which indicates that nickel is present in second ionization state. And configuration you can easily write, this is going to be 4s will be 0, and we are left with only 3d8. So this is the representation of the configuration for us. So you can represent like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now what we have, look, this is a strong field ligand. So same like the previous one, we are going to do pairing of this one. So after the pairing, these are going to be filled like this. And we are left with, this is our 3d basically, this is our 4s. And 4p is already vacant. Now we need to have a total of orbitals of 4 for the arrangement of the ligand. So it is undergoing dsp2 type of hybridization which we are talking about. So this is going to be our d x square minus y square, and it is contributing s, and it is contributing px and py. So this is the term which I want to show you how the contribution take place, and this is going to form a square planar geometry. Square planar. That's why I have also explained the tetrahedral case where sp3 will be formed, and in this case dsp2, so it's going to be square planar. So this was the whole classification. By now you have understood how the working will take place. So correspondingly for a square planar, answer is going to be option B.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download DoubtNit app today.